Hey friends, in this video I'm going to share with you my Kung Pao chicken stir fry recipe. Obviously it's a fusion of Kung Pao chicken and stir fry. I'm going to use the Panda Express Kung Pao stir fry sauce, which I got from Walmart. Also, instead of using the red bell peppers and squash, which are in the original Kung Pao recipe, I'm using frozen veggie stir fry mix, which I also got from Walmart. I like it more because it has more vegetables and also I don't have to chop any veggies. All the ingredients in this recipe are easily available at your local grocery store. Let's see what all you are gonna need for it. These are the two types of stir fry mix which I got last time when I went shopping. I think this time I'm going to use this one because it has the baby corn, which I really love. So what else are we going to use? Of course, chicken. I'm just cooking for two people tonight, so I am using half a pound of chicken. You can use the thighs or breast, whichever meat you prefer. Also, we are going to need some peanuts for garnishing. Onion, chopped ginger, hot red chilies. You can use fresh or dry. I have fresh, that's why I'm using these. Some salt and pepper, as well as cooking oil. You're also going to need Kung Pao stir fry Panda Express sauce, some soy sauce, sesame oil, and cornstarch. So first of all, let's marinate the chicken. You're going to need some of the ginger, not all of it, I'm saving some for later. About a teaspoon of soy sauce, pinch of salt, and just a little bit of cornstarch. This much should be fine. Mix it. We're gonna keep it in the fridge for at least 30 minutes. If you don't have time, you can cook it right away. Else keep it in the fridge for some time, at least 30 minutes. And meanwhile, you can chop your vegetables and roast the peanuts. What I really like about this recipe is that I'm just using one pot for everything. So first, let's dry roast some peanuts. It should take 2 or 3 minutes. My heat is on medium. Stir in between. Once you start getting the color, switch it off and remove from the heat. Now my peanuts look done. As you see, they have changed their color. Also, they are peeling off, which is another way to tell that they are done. I'm gonna take them off, switch off the heat. Have your veggies chopped, because once we start cooking, everything is going to be fast, so it's good to have everything prepared. Chicken is marinated now. Heat your pan on medium and add some oil. I'm using olive oil, around 3 tablespoons. You can actually increase your heat above medium. We are going to cook the chicken for a few minutes. Distribute it in one layer so that it cooks evenly. Don't move it immediately. Let it get a crust. After 1 minute, you can try to mix it. Let's mix it. As you see, it already changed the color. It's becoming white. We're going to cook it for a few minutes until it's golden brown, and then take it out on a plate. So it took around 5 to 6 minutes. As you see, the chicken is looking well cooked. So we are going to take it out on a plate. Try to keep the oil in the pan as we are going to fry the vegetables now. Start by adding your ginger. Fry it for 30 seconds. Next go the green chili, red chili, whatever chili you are using, dry chili if you don't have fresh, and the onions. My heat is above medium. We are going to fry until onions are soft, and then we are going to add our vegetable stir fry mix. It took me 3 minutes. Now my onions are soft and about to get golden, so it's time to add some vegetables. I think this should be good for 2 people. I'm not adding any salt because I'm using the Kung Pao stir fry sauce, which already has some. Also, I added some salt in the chicken. Just fry these for 2-3 minutes. Mix your veggies once in a while. These vegetables don't need much time. So 2-3 minutes, and as you see, they are already soft, no more frozen. So I'm adding the chicken. Next thing that goes is the Kung Pao stir fry sauce. I believe I used 1/4 cup of it. Add some black pepper to taste. In the end, you can garnish with green onions if you like them. I'm just using some peanuts as I don't have green onions right now. It looks a little bit dry to me, so I'm going to add a bit more of the Kung Pao sauce. So, turn off your heat, just give it a final stir, and it's ready to serve with some rice. I'm going to serve it with fried rice. You can also check my link for the egg fried rice which I have uploaded. It will be in the description box below. One last thing. add a teaspoon of sesame oil, which will give nice flavor to the dish. It's ready to serve. Dear friends, my meal is ready. I hope you liked my version of Kung Pao chicken. Let me know if you liked it. Thank you for watching. See you next time.